about the poacher type of dog. A poacher would like to be discreet, so if he goes about in hunting, and normally a poacher would not target that much carnivores, so predator type of dogs, or quarry, so like foxes, badgers, etc. Because oftentimes these type of quarry are not nice to eat. Often a poacher does it for getting access to meat which he can sell. Sometimes, however, also foxes or badgers are hunted because of their coat, for example, or other uses, or they are paid to take care of the predators. There could be a different type. Poaching is normally the hunting without having a permit to hunt, and also oftentimes they do not abide by the rules that the hunting association would want them to abide with. So if they want to be discreet in their ways, because otherwise they could be penalized very easily by the gamekeepers or police or the owner of the land, for example, then it would be wise that you have, if you are using dogs and also other hunting tools, of course, because you can also poach without a dog, I think many poachers do. But if you are using dogs, then you want a dog that is discreet. So for example, small enough to be tucked away. Also small enough to be not that easily noticed. So that could be a good thing. So often a terrier would be a good way to do this. If you have a black terrier, it will also be very hard to see them at night, because they do not reflect light, especially if you keep the eyes shut. Also, oftentimes, for example, poachers, mostly, as I mentioned, when you are looking for food, the best quarry is often rabbits, or deer, or even hawk. And then it would be a good thing, especially with the rabbits and deers, that you have a dog that's hard to distinguish as a dog suitable for poaching. So, for example, running type of dogs are very good at catching rabbits, but then you already see that it's a running dog, because of its silhouette, etc. But there are other types of ways to go about this. For example, if you have a dog like the Redlington Terrier, it carries running dog lineage, blood, but also terrier lineage. So it's a dog that's suitable for a multitude of things. Also it's a little bit stronger than your average whippet, and it's smaller even. And it is hard to see that it's a running type of dog, because of all the curls that just make it hard to see the silhouette. It looks a lot more beefy than it is, so it's a very fast type of dog still. But with the benefit that it's just better at working stronger quarry, for example, even the fox, or a stronger rabbit, so to say, it could even be used on a little bit bigger quarry. It's harder to do to see that it is a running type of dog, because it is camouflaged. And you also have benefits that the coat protects it more against the cold, the weather, and also brushes, for example. If you're brushing rabbits, then it's a better dog than just using a purebred whippet. And also it has some terrier blood in it, so it could be used also to a smaller degree, because it's more of an all-rounder, also for some earth work. So there you have it. That's an example. Also examples of the bigger type of lurchers, because if you combine a running dog with another type of dog, often these crosses are called lurchers, even between different strains of running dog. For example, Saluki and Greyhound are sometimes referred to as lurchers. But in my opinion, it's often a stronger type of dog, especially for its size, combined with a running type of dog, so that you have both the strength, increase and still maintain a lot of speed, and also often you get better feet for the rougher terrain. And in a latter sense, they're also crossbreeding collie type of dogs, for example, with with greyhounds to make bigger type of running lurchers that are very good for the terrain, have a better coat to protect them, and are harder to discriminate as running type of dogs that could be useful for poaching or other hunting activities. Also, sometimes you see other crosses being used, for example, soft coat of Wheaton Terrier. He also carries a big strong coat, could also be combined for similar effects, and then you would be closer to a bigger size Bennington Terrier, more of a greyhound size Bennington Terrier. And even the British cross, if you select right, you're able, both with the Wheaton and Polly, to breed a lot of a high percentage running dog and still have the camouflage effect of the coat. For example, even a 75% greyhound, 25% Polly could still carry a lot of camouflaging coat. And same with the Wheaton Terrier. Well, I hope this video was informing to you and also gives you some more insight in this breed development. Have a nice day. Bye bye.